October 2 is a very important day of our country. We celebrate this day as Gandhi Jayanti. It's a birthday of Mahatma Gandhi, the father of our nation. We also call him Bapu with great respect and affection.
Long ago, on this day in 1869, a cute little baby was born in Porbandar town in Gujarat. Father Karamchand Gandhi and mother Puteli Bai named the baby Mohan, Mohandas Karamchand Gandhi. As a child, he was greatly influenced by the honesty and strict discipline of his father and by the simplicity and religious thoughts of his mother.
At a very early age, the shy little child learned great values of truthfulness, integrity, honesty, and discipline. He lived these values throughout his life and proudly demonstrated the power of these values to the entire world.
When Mohan grew older, like many other teenagers, he also fell in bad company and picked up few bad habits such as smoking and stealing.
But soon, he realized his mistake and decided to confess. He wrote down everything on a piece of paper and put it in the hands of his father, who was sick. In the letter, he asked for punishment and promised never to repeat the mistake. His father read the letter and without uttering a word, tore up the paper with a deep sigh. Tears rolled down his cheeks and he lay down. Mohan realized how much his father loved him.
Later on, he came to understand that this was his honest confession that made his father react in this totally unexpected non-violent way. This incident left a lasting mark on his mind. He realized the power of truth. From that day, he took a resolution to always tell the truth. The incident also revealed to him the calming and healing power of non-violence or hinsa, which could transform everything. Later, he took it up as a weapon in a country's struggle for freedom.
In May 1893, after completing his education, he got an offer to go to South Africa as a legal advisor to an Indian firm. He went to Natal in South Africa. In those days, there was discrimination between the white and the colored people. In South Africa, Indians were ill-treated and disgraced. They were called coolies. Very soon, Gandhiji too had his share of this experience.
He was traveling to Pretoria in a first-class compartment. On the way, a European passenger entered the compartment and found Gandhiji in it. He complained to the station master, "Take this coolie out and place him in the lower class." Gandhiji raised an objection that he had a first-class ticket, but nobody heard him. A policeman threw him out with his bag and baggage. It was a very humiliating experience.
He decided to fight against this inhuman color discrimination and helped the Indians living there in the struggle for civil rights.
Ha! However, unlike other contemporary protesters, he took up the weapon of truth and nonviolence, which he laid a name as Satyagraha fight against the injustice.
After coming back to India in 1915, Gandhiji decided to fight against the injustice of British towards his countrymen. Very soon, many peoples from all over the country joined him. They started calling him Bapu and Mahatma. Along with his followers, Gandhiji non-violently united whole India against the British rule. Gandhiji emphasized on Satyagraha as the method to be followed in the national against the British.
Finally, the British understood that it would not be possible to rule India in the face of such opposition and decided to go back to their own country. Our country got independence on August 15, in 1947. It was the first time in the history of the world and mankind that a huge victory was achieved by Satyagraha. The whole world has recognized the greatness of Bapu and his normal method of Satyagraha or non-violence protest.